Jason, Clear Creek Farm, how are we doing today? Today we're out here using the ValueStore ultrasound machine to check some does. So the first thing we want to do is shave down here on their belly so that way the probe gets a better contact, makes it a little easier to see. So we got the ultrasound gel on here. We'll take and put this up on her. You can actually use alcohol or sanitizer or something like that instead of buying the actual gel. This is the actual ultrasound machine. It's pretty easy to operate. As you can see, this is all white here on the screen. All we had to do is turn it on. There's a little button here on the side. And it's ready to go. You don't really got to adjust nothing or anything. This probe works the best. Had a couple other people recommend us getting this probe. And then you just come up under here in the general area, back just in front of the bag area. And you rub that lube in there. And then you just move it around till you find what you're looking for. Sometimes it's a little harder than others. And usually it's just like a black void.
Right there.
Yep, a black void right there. If I get it moved right, you can kind of see the baby in the back of it. It's not as easy
right there. As
some people think it is. This is not super expensive ultrasound machine, but it works for what needs to be done. So we got another doe up here on the stand. Like I said, I just turned it on. Hit the menu key, and this time we're not going to use the gel. We're actually going to use hand sanitizer. I'll rub it on her belly and try it that way. And all you're trying to do is make it so it's easier to get contact with their skin. Sometimes they don't like it. Easy.
Very nice stuff. It's already right there anyway.
Is it right there?
Mm-hmm. Right there, you see? Right there. See it moving?
So she is bred.
I see guts. No, Dixie. Spot. I just don't know about it.
Well, then,
I'm not really seeing
right that. There. What's that?
Yeah, that's the one spot I'm talking about.
Half my lube fell off, so we'll use some of the hand sanitizer.
I see it down here on the stand.
Easy.
push her over on the other side. Second, we got good contact.
There, looks like. So we just ordered this ultrasound machine off of Amazon. I will leave a link down below. It's by ValueStoreUS. It's just a general veterinary ultrasound scanning machine. It don't really have a name brand from what I can find, but I will leave a link down below. Today was the first time we got it out of the box. It took us a little time to figure out where we needed to hold it, how we needed to hold it. But once we figured it out, using the actual ultrasound lube or using hand sanitizer, both works great. You just got to make sure there's enough up there to get a good contact. Would I recommend this to somebody wanting to get an ultrasound machine? Most definitely. I know a few friends of mine that runs quite a few goats, and they love their ultrasound machine, and that's why we ended up picking one up. It's way cheaper than having a vet out. It cost us about $1,000 to get this ultrasound machine, so it's not a cheap thing, but it's well worth it because you can check more often if you're worried about a goat being bred. You don't have to pay that fee for the vet to come out. And you have it always on hand if you need to check something. So being our first time using the ultrasound machine, it probably took us 45 minutes to an hour. We had 12 that we scanned, and 12 were all confirmed bred. So it works good, and it's not a big learning curve. If you like this video, please leave us a thumbs up. That helps YouTube know that our videos are worth watching and that you guys are enjoying the videos, and it helps other get them out to other people that might be interested in the goats, in the ultrasound machine, and different things like that. So please leave us a comment down below. Thank you for coming along with us today as we scan some does, and have a great day, and see you on the next video.